Trade finance are short-term loans made to finance a specific trade transaction. They're different than corporate loans in that you are actually financing a transaction. You're giving a loan for that transaction, not for the corporate entity that's taking the money. And in many cases, the goods that are being financed serve as collateral to that transaction. So the lender or the bank requires that any payments that come in go to pay off the loan. It's a pretty large market, about $19 trillion in 2015. With about 80% of that requiring some form of financing. We look at about 600 to 800 transactions per year, for example. With rising interest rates in the US, anybody who fears that and wants to participate in those rising interest rates should be, and is looking for a floating rate asset class, should be interested in trade finance. It has very attractive distribution yields, very low volatility, and tends to have negative or low correlation with many other asset classes. It's a very difficult asset class to access by financial investors. It requires a lot of infrastructure in terms of safekeeping, settlement, which many institutions don't have. Also, it requires a specific skill set in terms of personnel to actually analyze the specific deals. Additionally, as we said before, the asset class is dominated by commercial banks who tend to originate those transactions and hold it on their own balance sheets. We seek to invest along those banks on the same financial terms. Anti-trade measures generally create inefficiencies and make trade finance more expensive, i.e. wider spreads. So for example, after the 2008 crisis, when global trade reduced from about $16 trillion to about $12 trillion, we saw significant spread widening. I suspect this would be the same case here. However, we actually look at that as an opportunity to be able to buy the same risk, the same transactions, at wider spreads, higher yields, than you could in the past.